Hi, Sandro Mamukelashvili here, and watching my story.
Wow, what a dunk by Sandro Mamukelashvili.
Sandro comes from Alexander in Georgia. Sandro is a real name. Some of them, they say short version of Alexander, so growing up there, nobody really used to call me Alexander and just went to the shorter version and I became Sandro. Mamu came a little later in my life when I came to States, just especially because they could never pronounce my last name. So instead of butchering it, I think they just started calling me Mamu. And you know, Sandro is your name and like Mamu is your acting name. You know, just kind of fits. So I love my nickname. So if somebody asks me where I'm from, I always say I'm from Eastern Europe, country of Georgia, a small country. Great food and great wine, you know, full of surprises, so you should definitely visit. I grew up in Georgia until I was 13, and I always told my parents I want to go to the States or somewhere just so I can change the environment, work on my game a little bit more. So I remember this guy reached out on Facebook to me, and he was like, hey, one of your friends told me you are a good player, you wanna go to Italy? What made the thing hard was his profile picture. It was nothing related to basketball. It was just him on the beach with like a pier in the back. And he was like this, smiling at the camera. And I'm like, oh no. So I went to my dad. I'm like, yo, this guy texted me on Facebook. My dad, of course, just laughed at me. He said, nobody just gonna text you on Facebook if you wanna go to Italy to play. So I go in and I keep texting the guy and he sets up three tryouts for me and even the ticket. So at that point, I went back to my dad. I'm like, yo, we got the ticket, everything's set up. For my dad, I feel like at the point, it was like a free trip to Italy, you know? So he was like, okay, let's go. So we go, the first place was terrible. My dad told me he would never send me there. And the second place was Pallacanestro Biella, which was a great youth program, great Serie A2 team who had a Serie A team for a long time. You know, great developing coach, Federico Danna, and you know, it just looked like a perfect fit for both of us. Unfortunately, the team reached out back to me and he said the guy who I was trying out with, they liked him more, and we just let it be. But some didn't go as planned with the other guy, and he decided to call me back and tell me like if I want to still go, they would be interested in me. So I went there. I think it was a great decision from their part and my part. It was the best step in my life, developing wise and growing up wise. I had to mature a lot quicker. And I loved it, man. Italy was like my favorite place because of my teammates, my coaches, and the way they just welcomed me and their families, you know. After that, I went to Montverde Academy for my senior year.
As Mamukelashvili pounds at home, Mamukelashvili showing off his ring.
Wow, what a dunk by Sandro.
You know, I had a great team full of great players like RJ Barrett, Leaky Black, Marcus Carr, Andrew Nembhard, all these great guys who were ranked. So I went up there and, you know, tried to figure out the American style of basketball, which was very tough. You know, the United States was mental on the court more, like you're not the main guy now. Like I was ranked like third in Europe. I was one of the best players. Everybody loved me. I mean, come in a new space, and I feel like that kind of gave me that mentality where like, oh yeah, if you don't take care of yourself, like nobody will. I didn't know much about college basketball. The only team I knew was Miami and Duke. So once the team started calling me, I really didn't communicate with them, which made my process a little harder. By God, I found Senior Hall, went there and just developed every year, got better as a person, as a player, and I just loved it. My freshman year, I didn't play at all. I played like 7 minutes, so I was like, I'm never making it to the NBA. You realize like, okay, like, I'm not playing here, like, I think it's over. And then, you know, talking to my coach, which I love very much and I respect because he told me, I'll send the seniors away. And from sophomore year, I promise you, you know, start every game for me and I'm gonna give you the opportunity to reach the highest level.
What a feed by Sandro!
sophomore year, I started figuring out what I had to figure out my freshman year. And by junior year, I was already playing great.
Wow, they throw it up the Mamu, and it goes at the buzzer! Oh my goodness!
Then senior year, you know, I went in there, won Biggest Player of the Year and everything, and just was locked in that I would make it no matter what. To me, in my own path, I feel like I was very blessed to go to Milwaukee first.
Mamukelashvili. Oh, pure. So David Davis.
Just going into a mentality where like it's win now, we don't win, you know, we have an issue. And just being there and kind of figuring out with the guys who already have it figured out. And I feel like for me, it's just only you could do is be a sponge and listen. Yeah, and San Antonio is like developing great talent around you who you know who are gonna like achieve so much in their careers. Even being around young guys, like I learned so much, as well as me show them like what I got shown. It's the same way like I'm learning from them and their experiences. And of course you can't forget the coaching staff, Pop, you know, that's Hall of Famer there. So, you know, every time you say something, you just listen, and I feel like that's gonna just help you have a longer NBA career. You know, with the NBA, it's so up and down. You don't know. Sometimes it doesn't go your way, but it's a mental game, 99%. You can't mentally break. You can't mentally fold. Just got to keep going, keep fighting, and, you know, just believe in yourself. I'm sure, like, if you have faith, everything I take care of itself.
Victor ahead. Watch out. Inside. Yeah!